Hello, and thank you for tuning in. My name is Dee Norris. I'm the director of this production, and we had a really good time putting this together, so I hope you enjoy it just as much as we did. So sit back and check out The Chronicle of Wasted Time by Ben DeWitt.
Hey, Lucy, can you hear me?
Hey, Avon, long time no see.
Glad you finally got the Wi-Fi turned back on at your place. Have things calmed down over there? With your dad, I mean.
Well, you know how it is. So how's quarantine life treating you?
I mostly sit around doing school, listening to music, chatting with Bass. Mom and Dad make me come out to have lunch and dinner with them. It's this whole family togetherness thing Mom saw on Facebook.
How terrible for you.
It's fine. They just, they're good people. I shouldn't complain. It's been a lot of the same, though. But hey, now you're here.
I'm here. But where is here? This whole Zoom call thing is so strange. Like I'm performing for you or you're performing for me. It's not like when we could just be or do whatever we were doing together. I don't think I'm ever going to be able to get used to this. Is this what life's been like in the last 2 weeks?
Oh, we're not performing. We're just together. The new normal isn't normal, but at least we can talk.
I guess, but if this goes on too long, I'm just going to become a maladapted hermit and only come out when I have proclamations about the end times.
They'd totally believe you if you said the end is nigh.
Seriously nigh. They'd say I'm crazy if I started saying that everything's going to be okay. Like, people of the world, life is puppies and rainbows and... Avon, I gotta go. I think my dad's at it again. He shouldn't catch me.
But Lucy, I wanted to tell you...
Don't tell me. Make me a playlist. Email me?
Sure, Lucy. I won't tell you. Let's see. Love songs. This project may be hopeless. Let's try some T Swift. I'm gonna say no.
If I should stay, I would only be in your way.
There's only you in my life, the only thing that's bright.
My first love.
No, too much commitment. Too soon.
To live in memory. angel, will you be mine?
Not one.
My darling,
not a single one.
Not a single what, you magnificent sack of cheese fries and caffeine?
Hey, Bass. There aren't any songs.
I just heard you go through, like, three, so.
No, there aren't the right songs. The ones I need to... you wouldn't understand.
Right. So, how are things going with you and Lucy Lanier?
They were fine. She finally got her internet back, and we got to talk for, like, a second. Now I'm ruining everything. I mean, you know she doesn't go for labels or anything. I get that. She's not my whatever.
Girlfriend? No, she's not your girlfriend.
Well, now she'll never be. I tried to, like, talk to her about it, and she told me to show her how I feel with a playlist.
Dude, that's easy. There are thousands of songs out there.
Millions! And you know something really interesting about all the love songs in human history?
What's that?
They all suck.
Hang on. Okay, hang on. Love songs are the basis of the music industry.
They're all the same. They all talk about what you will or won't do for someone, or use some marketable metaphor to say how they're your sunshine or your ride or die or whatever.
You are overthinking this. Just throw on half a dozen songs from her favorite bands, three or four songs of your favorites, and then slip a couple of really dirty ones in there to see what she's down for. Well, don't look at me like that. It shows her that you know and understand her and are willing to share a piece of yourself with her. And if she's into it, maybe you get to share other pieces.
No, it's got to be perfect. Yeah. All mass market music has ever produced is crap.
So go before the market was mass. I don't know. My effervescent can of anxiety and hormones.
What, like Beethoven or something?
Yeah, sure. I don't know. Look, my scintillating suitcase of romance and cinnamon mouthwash, I gotta get some sleep. If I think of anything, I'll text you.
You never text me.
True, but I'll check in with you in the morning. Same Zoom time, same Zoom channel.
Later. What are really old love songs like? Oh, sonnets. Shakespeare wrote like 200 of the greatest love poems of all time. From fairest creatures we desire increase. No, she already feels on the spot when we talk. I don't need anything from her. She is the fairest creature though. What about number 3? No. 4? No. 5, 6. Ugh, all so close. Music to hear. Why here's to the music sadly? Because the music I was looking through all stink, shaky baby, that's why. Oh wait, this. When in the Chronicle of Wasted Time, I see descriptions of the fairest whites. I see their antique pen would have expressed even such beauty as you master now. For we, which now behold these present days, have eyes to wonder, but lack tongues to praise. This is it. I just need Shakespeare to meet her and write her a sonnet. It'd be perfect. I lack the tongue to praise, and he lacks the fairest white that ever there was. He needs to meet her and write me the perfect poem. Damn.
I hate to wake your sleeping rest so sound, but I would like to know what place I find myself this night. I opened my eyes and found your visage prone with sleep, both mute and blind. 'Tis not a specter before you stands. 'Tis only I, an actor and a bard. I've heard a plea for help from far off lands, but aiding you with sleep, that will be hard.
You are Shakespeare. The William Shakespeare. How are you? What are you? You Zoom bombed me?
In every generation comes a plague that keeps the theaters dark and souls remote. This fuels the magic. How? That is still vague. Just know that I am here to write, to get thy poem wrote.
Plague quarantine magic has brought William Shakespeare from the 1590s to help me write the perfect sonnet for the girl I love? That's awesome!
I thought this news would wake your sleeping heart. Now, tell me about this girl so I can start.
Okay, give me a second. Let me get myself together. Bass is never gonna believe this. Okay, Lucy. She's perfect.
While silence is the perfectest display of love, for words can faint of love express. If you want me to write your heart, then say the things that make her perfect. I digress.
Yeah, well, she's so authentic. She always tells the people around her just how she's feeling, and I can always tell she really wants me to be my real self.
A mask's a foul thing to be forced behind. A lady who removes your mask is wise, but better still, together we can find a visor that reveals your aching size.
Wow, that's good. Aching size. I mean, how I feel doesn't ache exactly, but still, you're the Shakespeare here, right?
That is my name. Describe me Lucy's face.
She has this huge smile that she hardly ever uses. That's what makes it so special. It takes up her whole face, like it's a crime she doesn't get to smile so much, because her face is made for smiling. Her cheeks dimple, her eyes flash, her forehead crinkles. It's everything.
The gem of beauty has more value when 'tis rarely seen, and rarely in your grace.
And she's smart. She's always thinking about what everything means. Figuring out people, politics, religion. Her mind works nonstop. It makes her so fascinating and challenging. I gotta stay smart just to keep up. I love that.
That's more than ink you fed into my pen. Your praise of cheek, of eye, of mind, and brow are in the hands of me, the master now.
My deluded jar of dreams and unicorns. What couldn't wait?
William Shakespeare Zoom bombed my call.
What?
He heard my wish beyond all time and space, and the magical connection of two plague quarantine civilizations fueled by my heart's wish brought him here. So I told him all about Lucy. I showed him pictures, and now he's going to write a sonnet for me that gives the greatest poet of all time the chance to sing with his full skill of the best woman to ever walk the planet.
Buddy, no.
What do you mean, no?
No, you just gave some creepy old British guy who bombed your late night Zoom call a bunch of pictures of Lucy and told him all about her. No, he's going to be making some creepy deep fakes or going to be stalking her or something, okay?
No, it's not like that. It was
really... Avon, no. You don't give pictures of the girl you like to strangers on the internet.
It was William Shakespeare. Oh. Quake played quarantine magic.
Okay, the only magic of quarantines is getting to do work in your pajamas. You got played. Okay, it's probably nothing. Not I. Deal, but okay.
She's gonna hate me forever. He's probably some kind of creeper who shares pictures of their friends with strangers on the internet.
You should probably limit social interactions online after 2 a.m. Nothing good happens after 2. Okay,
so. No, I just.
Yeah, you should have known.
Avon, Sebastian.
Hey, Lucy.
Hey, Lewis.
Sebastian, can you give us a minute?
Sure. I'll get some chips.
Avon, I just got the strangest email.
Look, I can explain. All the songs were stupid to start with, but then Bass was there, and I was sleep-deprived, and had totally convinced myself that he'd really come, and then when he did come...
Why didn't you sign it? Why make a fake email account just to send me a poem?
A fake what now?
The sonnet you wrote me. I know it was from you. It could only be from you.
Oh, yeah. From me. Totally not from a stranger that looked like William Shakespeare that I randomly met online and showed pictures of you and told all about you.
You are so strange.
I know. I'm glad you liked it.
So this is it. You two in love. And I'm left here alone to end it with a rhyme.
See, can you hear me?
Avon, hey, long time no see.
Yeah, glad you finally got the Wi-Fi turned back on at your place. Have things calmed down over there? With your dad, I mean?
You know how it is. So how's quarantine life treating you?
I mostly sit around doing school, listening to music, chatting with Bass. Mom and Dad make me come out to have this lunch and dinner with them. It's like this whole family togetherness thing that my mom saw on Facebook.
How terrible for you.
It's fine. They're good people. I shouldn't complain. It's been a lot of the same here, though. But hey, now you're here.
I'm here. Where is here? This whole Zoom call thing is strange. Like, I'm performing for you, or you're performing for me, or it's not like when we could just be and do whatever we were doing together. Is this what life's been like in the last 2 weeks? I don't know if I'll be able to get used to this.
Lucy, we're not performing, we're just together. I mean, the new normal is not normal, but at least we can talk.
I guess. If this keeps up too long, maybe I'll just become a maladapted hermit and only come out when I have proclamations about the end time.
They would totally believe you if you said the end is nigh.
Seriously nigh. They'd say I'm crazy if I started telling everyone that everything's going to be okay. People of the world, doom and gloom is a myth. Life is puppies and rainbows and... I gotta go, Avon. It sounds like Dad's at it again. He shouldn't catch me.
But Lucy, I wanted to tell you.
Don't tell me. Make me a playlist. Email me.
Sure, Lucy. I won't tell you. Let's see. Love songs. Project may be hopeless. Let's try some T-Swift.
My daddy said stay away from Juliet, and I was crying on the staircase, begging you please don't go. And I said, you'll take me somewhere we can be alone. I'll be waiting.
I'm gonna say no.
If I should stay, I would only be in your way. There's only you in my life.
Too much commitment. Too soon.
off my mind.
Not one. Not a single one.
Not a single what, you magnificent sack of cheese fries and caffeine.
Oh, hey, Bass. There aren't any songs.
I just heard you go through, like, three.
No, there aren't any of the right songs. The ones that I need to... You wouldn't understand.
Right. So, how are things going with you and Lucy Lanier?
They were fine. She finally got her internet back and we got to talk for like a second. Now I'm ruining everything. I mean, you know she doesn't go for labels or anything. Like, I get that. She's not my whatever.
She's not your girlfriend.
And now she'll never be. I tried to like talk to her about it and she told me to show her how I feel with a playlist.
Easy. There are thousands of songs out there.
Millions. And you know something really interesting about all of the love songs in human history?
What's that?
They all suck.
Love songs are the basis of the music industry.
And they are all the same. They all talk about what you will or won't do for someone or use some marketable metaphor to say how they're your sunshine or your ride or die or whatever.
You are overthinking this. Just throw on half a dozen songs from her favorite bands, three or four of your favorites, and then slip a couple of really dirty ones in to see what she's set out down for. Don't look at me like that. It shows her that you know and understand her and are willing to share a piece of yourself with her. And if she's into it, maybe you can get it to share some other pieces of, you know.
No, it's got to be perfect. And all that mass market music has ever produced is crap.
So go before the market was mass, my effervescent can of exciting hormones.
What, like Beethoven or something?
Oh, sure. I don't know. Look, my scintillating suitcase of romance and cinnamon mouthwash. I gotta get some sleep. If I think of anything, you know, I'll just...
You never text me.
True. But I'll check in with you in the morning. Same Zoom time, same channel.
Later.
Later.
What are really old love songs like? Let's see. Sonnets. Shakespeare wrote like 200 of the greatest love poems of all time. Let's see. From fairest creatures, we desire increase. No, she already feels on the spot when we talk. I don't need anything from her. She is the fairest creature though. Let's see, what about number three? No. Four? No. Five. Six. Ah. All so close. Music to hear. Why hearest thou music sadly? Because the music I was looking through all stinks, shaky baby, that's why. Let's see. Wait. This. When in the Chronicle of Wasted Time, I see descriptions of the fairest rites. I see their antique pen would have expressed even such beauty as you master now. For we, which now behold these present days, have eyes to wonder, but lack tongues to praise. This is it. I just need Shakespeare to meet her and write her a sonnet. It would be perfect. I lack the tongue to praise, and he lacks the fairest rite that ever there was. He needs to meet her and write me the perfect poem. Damn it.
hate to wake your sleeping rest so sound, but I would like to know what place I find myself this night. I opened my eyes and found your visage prone with sleep, both mute and blind. Tis not a specter that before you stands, tis only I, an actor and a bard. I've heard a plea for help from far off lands, but aiding you asleep, that will be hard.
You are Shakespeare. The William Shakespeare. How are you? What are you? Did you Zoom bomb me?
In every generation comes a plague that keeps the theaters dark and souls remote. This fuels the magic. How? That is still vague. Just know I'm here to get thy poem wrote.
Plague quarantine magic has brought me William Shakespeare from the 1950s to help me write the perfect sonnet for the girl that I love. That's awesome.
I thought this news would wake your sleeping heart. Now tell me about this girl so I can start.
Okay. Give me 1 second. Let me get myself together. Jeez. Bass is never gonna believe this. Okay, Lucy. She's perfect.
While silence is the perfectest display of love, for words can faint of love express, if you want me to write your heart, then say the things that make her perfect. I digress.
Yeah, she's so authentic. Mm-hmm. She always tells people around her how she's feeling, and I can always tell, she wants me to be my real self.
A mask's a foul thing to be forced behind. A lady who removes your mask is wise. But better still, together we can find a visor that reveals your aching sighs.
Wow, that's good, aching sighs. I mean, how I feel doesn't ache exactly, but still, you're the Shakespeare here, right?
That is my name. Describe me Lucy's face.
Okay. She has this huge smile that she hardly ever uses. That's what makes it so special. It takes up her whole face. Like, it's a crime that her face doesn't get to smile so much because it's a face made for smiling. Her cheeks dimple and her eyes flash, her forehead crinkles. It's everything.
A gem of beauty has more value when 'tis rarely seen and rarely in your grace.
And she's smart. Like, she's always thinking about everything, like what everything means, figuring out people and politics and religion. Her mind works nonstop. It makes her so fascinating and challenging. I gotta stay sharp just to keep up. And I love that.
That's more than ink you fed into my pen. Your praise of cheek, of eye, of mind and brow are in the hands of me, the master now.
Oh, hey, to my deluded jar of unicorns and dreams. What couldn't wait?
William Shakespeare Zoom bombed my call.
What?
He heard my wish beyond all time and space, and the magical connection of two plague quarantine civilizations fueled by my heart's wish brought him here. So I told him all about Lucy. I showed him pictures, and now he is going to write a sonnet for me. That gives the greatest poet of all time the chance to sing with his full skill of the best woman to ever walk the planet.
Oh, buddy, no.
What? What do you mean, no?
You just gave some creepy old British guy who bombed your late night Zoom call a bunch of pictures of Lucy? And told him all about her, he's got to be making some creepy deep fakes or gonna be stalking on her or something.
No, it's not like that. It was really...
No, you don't give pictures of the girl you like to strangers on the internet.
It was William Shakespeare, quarantine plague magic.
Only magic of quarantine is getting to do work in your pajamas. You got played. It's probably okay. Not ideal, but okay.
She's gonna hate me forever. He's probably some kind of creeper. Like, who shares pictures of their friends with strangers on the internet?
You should probably limit social interactions online after 2 a.m. Nothing good happens after 2 a.m.
I know,
Avon? Sebastian?
Hey, Lucy, what's up?
Sebastian, can you give us a minute?
Yeah, sure, just gonna...
Avon, I just got the strangest email.
Look, I can explain. So all of the songs were stupid to start with, but then Bass was there and I was sleep deprived and I had totally convinced myself that he had really come, and then when he did come and he was talking like his poems or whatever, he...
Why didn't you sign it? Why make a fake email account just to send me a poem?
A fake what now?
The sonnet you wrote me. It was beautiful. I knew it was from you. It could only be from you.
Oh, yeah, totally from me, not from some random stranger that I met on the internet and showed pictures of you and told all about you.
What? You're so strange.
I know. I'm glad you liked it.
So, this is it. You two in love, and I'm left here alone to end it with a rhyme.